Chance is here, grab it now before it disappears. Lady Luck is here today, move before she runs away. Keep your eye upon that dream and go for it.
Don't hang back, for life's too short. Second guessing is a loser sport. Throw your backs against the wall, now at least you got the ball. Blows, but know that you'll survive.
Put your mamas on the line.
If you lose, it ain't tried.
When you lose, you got the team.
So keep your eye upon the dream and go for it. Go for it
now.
Wait a minute. If you want to play good basketball, you gotta remember one thing. Your head has got to be like a sponge.
Sponge?
Yeah, sponge, Hustle. You gotta remember things. When you do something right, remember what it was. And when you do something wrong, you got to remember not to do it wrong anymore.
Can you say anything I'm doing wrong?
Yeah, Marvin, you're passing. Now, you pass well, and you're accurate, right? But you telegraph every time, Marvin. We should call you Mr. Morse. Beep, beep, beep. It's a joke, Marvin. Forget about it. What I'm trying to say is that your eyes told me where you were going every time. Your eyes.
My eyes? You think that's why I didn't get recruited by no college?
No, the rest of your game is solid. I wouldn't worry about it. Sometimes the best aren't always picked first.
Really? Who wasn't picked first?
Who? Cousy. How's that?
Who?
Bob Cousy.
Bob Cousy? Who is Bob Cousy?
Who is Bob Cousy? You guys don't know who Bob Cousy is?
No, I never heard of him.
Bob Cousy played college ball at Holy Cross. Was drafted by the Tri-City Blackhawks, right? Now, they're not too thrilled with him, so they traded him to the Chicago Stags team. Now, Chicago folds before the season starts. And Boston gets stuck with this Mr. Cousy, and they're not too thrilled with him either. He only plays 14 years for them, averages 18.4 a game, and is regarded as the best backcourt man to ever step on a basketball court, all right?
My man, incredible sponge man.
All right, okay.
Yeah.
Cousy.
Yeah.
Jan? Honey? Jenny Benanny? I am home. Darling? Hello? How you doing? How's every little thing? Everything's okay? Good. All right, let me tell you what happened, okay? You said come home between 7 and 7:30, right? So 6:45, I left the court, I was on my way home, but...
But what?
But what?
But what?
But I happened to run into this guy I was in the army with, I haven't seen him for 10 years, Eddie, and I...
Bullshit.
Eddie Bullshit, and I said, Eddie, how's your bullshit? And he said, fine, how's
your... You know
your...
what that is over there, David?
Accordion.
Don't get cute. Do you know what that is over there?
Phone.
It's a phone, that's right. You take your little finger and you put it in the hole and you go around 7 times and you call and you say you're going to be home late. It's very simple.
You're right. Can we get back to kissing?
Stop it. You're all sweaty and you smell of garlic.
I only had one slice. Just
when did
one
you
slice.
Ever have one slice?
I had 4 slices and 2 Coke.
Why don't you go take a shower?
Jan!
Stop it.
Jan.
You're hurting me.
I'm
Come
sorry.
Out.
Listen. You're mad and you got a right to be mad, okay? But let's discuss it like two mature adults, all right?
Mature. Guy spends half of his waking hours throwing a ball into a hoop and he talks about being mature.
Oh, you put me down.
It's amazing to me. You can remember who did what to who on a basketball court, but you can't remember to come home time for dinner.
Let's look at the man.
Let's look at the man.
Uh-oh, dentist. I think we have to pay this guy. He's starting to get surly.
Tooth hurts.
So go to the dentist.
Hey, I got an answer from this university I wrote.
Big deal.
Dear Mr. Green, I have studied your application with great interest. Cadwallader is in great need of a young and inventive basketball coach. My wife and I will be in New York City on the 12th. Please call us at the St. Moritz to set up an appointment. Yours truly, Alton Gutkus, President, Cadwallader University. I got an interview.
Please, let me see that. What's the name of the school?
Cadwallader.
Cadwallader. Obviously one of the top 10 schools in the country.
Hey, you know, I write a lot of letters, and I finally got an interview. You don't have to be so nasty.
I just don't want you to get hurt.
I'm not gonna get hurt.
Let's go take a shower.
You wanna take a shower?
Yeah.
All right, come on, let's go take a shower. You know, Jan, I got a good feeling about this.
I'm gonna give you a good feeling. I'm gonna wash a Cadwallader for you.
What's the spread on the Knicks tonight?
Knicks. The Knicks are 8-point underdogs. I like the Sonics.
I'll take the Knicks and 8 for 20.
Give you 6.
It's 8 points in the paper.
So bet with the paper, Henry. You're getting senile, you know that?
Hey, Benny, 648 and 187 is 835, not 735.
So where's the pickles?
Yeah. That guy on table 4 with the bad suit says the chicken salad is no good.
Which guy? They all got bad suits on table 4.
The little one.
Hey, mister. Mister, you gotta eat half a sandwich to find out it's no good?
I thought it'd get better. I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry, too. I gotta charge you for the sandwich.
I wouldn't pay a penny. The chicken salad's terrible.
What are you talking about? I just made it fresh this morning. I'll charge you for half a sandwich. Can I help you, sir?
Could you spare a piece of bread for a veteran?
You wouldn't make a habit of coming in here, would you?
No, sir.
You promised me. I don't want to see you in here anymore.
No, sir.
Let me have a knish for a veteran. Here, come here, come here. Here, take a nap. There you go.
Thank you, sir.
Thank
God bless you, sir.
God bless you, sir. Happy Veterans Day.
Listen, the guys and I are going to the track. I'll be back about 5 o'clock.
Wait a minute. I told you I got an appointment at 4:30.
Oh, yeah. I'll be back at 4.
All right.
You know, Davey, for my sake, I hope you don't get the job.
Why, thank you, Henry. Listen, I gotta leave 4:05. Are you back or not?
I'll be back at 4:04. Don't hock me. Don't hock me.
Appointment with Mr. Gutkus. Can you tell me what room he's in?
The house phone, sir.
He's expecting me. My name is David Green.
Look, the house phone, sir. They'll take care of you.
Mr. Alton Gutkus, please. Mr. Gutkus, hi. How are you? David Green. So, how do you like the 2307? Okay, be right up.
Green?
Yes.
Alton Gutkus.
Nice to meet you.
How are you? Buttercup, he's here.
Great,
come
Daddy.
In. Sit down. What are you drinking?
Nothing. Tomato juice.
How did you first happen to hear about Cadwallader?
Well, I grant you, Mr. Gutkus, a lot of people have probably never heard of Cadwallader, but I've always found the school kind of interesting, sort of a gem in the wilderness.
Yeah, a gem in... Oh, Buttercup, Mr. Green's always thought of us as a gem in the woods.
You look so pretty.
Oh, thank you.
Buttercup, I'd like you to meet Mr. David Green. David, my bride, Enid Cadwallader Gutkus.
Nice to meet you, Mrs. Gutkus.
Oh, that's Cadwallader Gutkus. Yeah. And it's nice to meet you, too.
Well, Buttercup, what do you think?
Well, for a basketball coach, I thought there'd be a little bit more to him.
What Enid means is she thought you'd be taller.
Oh, well, I jump high.
I love a sense of humor. He's ethnic, ain't it? Ain't it never met an ethnic before, did you, Buttercup?
Well, just a little bitty gardener once.
Well, I guess you want to go do your shopping. We're going to talk business.
Okay. Well, it's nice to have met you.
Nice to have met you, Mrs. Cadwallader Gutkus.
Jim in the wilderness, huh? Let's cut the bullshit. Nobody ever heard of Cadwallader. I never heard of Cadwallader until I met Enid. Sit down. But it's there, and I am the new president, and I do not intend to live my life in obscurity. I want to make Cadwallader a name. Some kind of ball team would do it. Football's too expensive. Basketball's only 5 men. That's where you come in.
Thank you. Why would you pick me?
Well, I liked your letter. You seem to know the game. You're a student of John Wooden's style. And most of all, I especially like the part where you said you'd work for nothing. I like that.
Well, you didn't take me literally at that. You don't really expect me to work for nothing, do you?
Well, I'll give you $50 for every game you win.
$50?
Cash.
A game?
When you win.
How many games are you going to play this year?
Well, we hope to have 30.
Well, wait, Mr. Gutkus. You say if I win every game, I'm going to make $2,000. $50 a game. Come on.
All right. Make it 60.
60.
Look, I know it's a long shot, but I'll give you room and board, $60 for every game you win, and I'll give you a regular contract if you beat Nevada State.
Nevada State? Come on, it's one of the top 10 teams in the country. What are you talking about?
Well, that's what makes it a long shot. I told you it was a long shot. But the day you beat Nevada State, I'll give you a 3-year contract at $30,000 a year with fringes.
You know, I think you're as crazy as I am. But I like your style. This is guaranteed $30,000 a year for 3 years?
I promise.
I just got to beat Nevada State?
Yeah.
Where do I get my players?
Anywhere you can.
What about scholarships?
Well, we'll give them room and board and a first-class education for any kid who wants to play with us.
Some of the best players I know have a little problem with academics.
Not a Cadwallader. You get my meaning?
You got yourself a deal, all right? Just to be fair, let's make it $100 a game, all right?
60.
Got it.
I got the job.
Never thought that would happen.
I was starting to believe it would never happen.
When do you start?
Yeah. Immediately. Jan, it's going to be terrific. They're going to give us our own furnished apartment, room and board. The food there is supposed to be terrific. And the money's not great the first year, only $2,500. But all I got to do is beat this one team, Nevada State, and make $30,000 a year for 3 years.
I'm not going, David.
What?
I said, I'm not going.
Why?
How can we live on $2,500?
We'll manage. It's only for 1 year. We got money in the bank.
You're not touching that money. That money's for the house.
What do you mean I'm not going to touch that money?
I said you're not going to touch that money. It's for the house.
Look, that money is half mine, and I'm going to touch it whenever I want to touch it. I was afraid this was going to happen.
I don't understand it. You have a good job. What do you want to blow it now for?
Because now is when I have the opportunity.
You have the opportunity to ruin a future.
Jan, I want to be a basketball coach. Don't you understand that? When I was coaching in junior high, that was the happiest time of my life. The kids were 12, 13 years old. They didn't know what the hell I was talking about. But this is what I want to do.
Well, it's not what I want to do. What about me, David? Don't I count?
Jan, I love you more than I've ever loved anybody. But I'm going to Nevada.
Well, I'm staying in New York.
Who is it?
Ma, it's me.
Me who?
Me, your son.
My son who?
How many sons do you have?
Give me a name.
Isn't a voice enough?
Give me a name.
David Benjamin.
Davy, it's past midnight.
Ma, you know, I think you're getting old. You're a little suspicious.
Suspicious, you bet, with the bums in the neighborhood. What was the fight about?
There was no fight.
Well, what are you doing with the suitcase?
Look, Ma, Jan and I, we just came to, like, an understanding.
Some understanding. You're here and she's there.
All right, I'll tell you what happened in the morning, all right? Good night. Hey, man, it's a chance to get an education. Tomorrow belongs to you. You got to think about your future.
Hey, I got my future in the bag. You know how much money I make?
Yeah, I can tell by the way you're dressed.
Come on, man, I got to dress down or I scam away.
Listen, Leroy, a pool hustler's life is nothing to look forward to. You know, there's not a lot of longevity involved.
Hey, I can go on forever. My act's too cool for these turkeys.
Yeah, too cool for these turkeys. You know, you better watch out. These turkeys get smart. One year, I might have you for Thanksgiving.
Hey, what's that in hell?
Get out.
Say what?
Say what? Get your ass out of here.
Come on, man. I'm only looking to play. Why you talk to me like that?
I don't want your action here. I'm gonna see to it you don't get any action in New York. And if you want any action, you better get on down to West Virginia.
Oh, come on, man.
Get out! And take that Puerto Rican with you.
Hey, hunky, what are you doing here?
This is my man. He's here to do a cover story for Time magazine.
Cover story for Time?
Yeah,
all
yeah.
Right.
Brothers and sisters, I come to you this evening, a humble messenger of the Grandmaster. Amen. The Grandmaster of the Church of the Celestial Being. I say humble because I am. Amen.
How does he move?
What?
How does he move? You give him a basketball and got more moves than a $100 hooker.
19 years old.
Nah.
Right out of the Harlem tenement.
All right.
And no education.
All
right. That's right, sister. No education. But I wears $400 suits. I walked around in $100 shoes. And I drives a brand new, which is parked right outside the church. Coop this beer. Come on, now, let me hear from you. Now, I'm going to tell you something else, and then I'm going to get off this stage. You know, the rich people would tell you that poverty is not a crime. Ain't that something? They will actually say that poverty is not a crime. And you want to know why they can tell you that? Because they ain't got no poverty. You got it. That's right.
Watch out!
Oh, shit!
man! Give her that gun! Put that thing down, man! Give her that gun! Get the car! Bring her around back! Huh? Car! Bring her around back!
Huh?
Come on, man. Answer the phone. Sonny.
Davey, what's going on here?
Nothing, Mama. Go rustle up some food. Yeah.
What'd he say?
So what kind of food do these people eat?
The same as us. Maybe not the same as you. Come on, I'll help you. Come on.
Okay.
Well, our father celestial soldiers gonna guard you?
Leroy, father celestial soldiers are trying to kill me.
What? I thought you was his protege.
I was. Leroy, he's got this daughter, see? Hot for my body. So when I was in Chicago, I was living at his house. The chick would come around to visit in the middle of the night. 3 o'clock in the morning, Leroy, man ain't thinking at all. So she's pregnant.
So what? Marry her.
Leroy, you don't marry God's daughter, especially when she's 15.
15?
What do you want from me? I'm only 19. There ain't no place safe for me, Leroy. Not here, Chicago, Los Angeles, Detroit. Oh, man, there's people everywhere.
Not everywhere.
I don't think.
On coke? Ever hear of a Cadwallader University?
No, man, I ain't never heard of. Say what?
Cadwallader.
No.
That's all right, nobody has.
Hey, what's happening, Daddy? Any luck?
Luck? I've been to 11 places today. Every kid I coached in junior high school. You want to know what the story is? 4 are in college already, 2 are in the Air Force, 1 is dead, 1 is in jail, and the rest whereabouts unknown. Don't ever become a bartender. Your strong point is not other people's problems. Which one is Swish?
The one with the ball. And a soft touch. See what I mean?
Amazing.
You know, I don't understand how come this Bobby James hasn't been snatched up by some college.
I don't know.
How well do you know him?
Not as well as I'd like to.
What the hell does that mean?
He's a drag queen?
No wonder they call him Swish.
You mean her?
Her?
Daddy, meet Roberta James.
Bobby.
Son of a bitch.
I'm already going to college. I started to fall at CCNY.
On a basketball scholarship?
Academic.
But that's crazy. You should be playing basketball.
Oh, really? Who's drafting females these days? Nobody let me play with the boys.
I'll let you play with me.
Shut up, hustler. You can play on my team. How bad do you want it?
Bad.
Bad enough to register as Robert James? It's a real nice block here, you know that? Where are we going?
Right here.
In here?
Yeah, that's right. Right in here, man.
You know, I'm not recruiting any rats this year. They eat too much cheese.
Come on, man. Be cool, all right?
We're really going in here.
Yeah, come on now. Let's go.
What's the matter, no doorman? Oh, well, once you get inside, it's not that bad.
Come on, man.
Did it have a swimming pool on the roof?
Hey, what's sounding ugly?
What you doing, Leroy?
Hey, all right.
Who's this guy, man?
Hey, relax, he's cool. Here, I brought you something.
Who is this man?
He's a basketball coach, that's all.
Uh-huh.
He don't look like no basketball coach to me.
Sure don't.
Looks more like a pig.
Hey, guys, I ain't no pig. Actually, I'm from the landlord, and your rent is overdue. How you doing? David Green.
Hey, man, get him out of here.
Hey, lighten up, man.
Get him out of here, man.
Hey,
come
give me
on,
my groceries,
let's go.
Man.
Let's go. Groceries. Come on.
Hey, you. You better forget you ever seen this place.
How would
God,
you,
this
DC?
Place is a memory.
DC. Daisy. Donald Clarence Stacy, Morris High School, 1976, 28.7 a game. 148 basketball scholarships, turns them all down and disappears, drops out of sight. DC Daisy. Give the man his groceries.
Congratulations. Hey, David, this is from the guys at the deli.
Oh, the guys at the deli. All right. They broke their heart. They poured me some. Oh, I wish so.
Let's hear it.
All right, listen, I want a fast break. Hustler, make a cut between the pickles and the mustard and dunk it right there in the coffee pot. This is Zook. I got to open this next.
Hey, DC, have some trouble. Go ahead, enjoy yourself.
Billy, you started to smoke.
Congratulations.
Ms. Zooka, thank you very much. Thank you. You always were a classy lady. Thank you. Ma, how you doing? Ma.
Fine, fine.
I don't see you.
You don't see her because she's not here. When she comes, you'll see her.
You spoke to her.
I spoke. Give her a chance. I think you should speak to that big kid, Dizzy.
DC, not Dizzy. DC.
Dizzy, DC. What's the difference?
Dizzy.
Somebody else would like some chopped liver.
Like who?
Like me.
Like you?
Yes.
I think in your life you had enough chopped liver. What do you think?
So, Mrs. Green, what do you think of your boy?
I think he's crazy. Basketball, Nevada.
He's a good boy, though. We're going to miss him.
I miss you too, David. Henry.
I got one for you boys. Who was the first black player in the NBA? You see that? You don't know. Nat Sweetwater Clifton. He played for the Knicks, 1949. You boys should know that. That's your roots.
Say, what was your name?
Arnie Dibber.
Dibber? Dibber. Who was the first white ball player to play in the NBA? Huh?
Ah, got to get to the roots, boy. Get down.
I'm getting down.
So what was that, about 18 months ago? Whoa, shut up, look at us. Excuse me, nice seeing you again.
Hi.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah, well, your mom said you're going to be leaving in the morning.
I couldn't call you. I'd have my mother do it, like a kid.
So I came by to say so long, and I hope you'll be very happy.
Jan.
Jan. Hi, Mom.
You look pale. Are you eating?
Yeah, no, I'm fine.
Come and eat.
Oh, no, you go and eat. Go ahead. We'll see you later. Go ahead, have something.
Goodbye.
You know, maybe I was dreaming, but I had this idea you might show up here with your luggage tonight.
I came here because I don't want us to be enemies.
That's very nice. Well, I don't want us to be just friends. I mean enemies. I got something for you. It's a plane ticket.
No,
you don't have to use it. Just take it. It's returnable, refundable, you can get money, anything you want. You never could tell. You could be driving by an airport and all of a sudden you get an urge and bing, bong, boom, you're in Nevada.
Bye, David. I'm scared.
I'm scared, too.
How's it look?
It's quiet, Mom.
Hey, man, any cops?
Nothing. Come on, relax.
Say, man, my pants are getting all wrinkled. The sucker's taking forever.
Here they come now.
What the hell is that? Look at that walk. We gotta spend 3 days in the car with a... Hey, man, he lays one hand on me and I'm gonna deck his ass.
Cute. Hey, look at that cow over there. Moo.
Man, to hell with the cow. All I want to know is how we gonna play ball with four players, huh?
Right.
We're gonna manage, that's how.
Fine, five players, dumb enough to go cat Atlanta.
Dad Waller.
Let's talk about dumb. Let's talk about why you here.
Sure, let's talk about why you here, you know?
Bro, who cares why anybody?
Oh, hey, wait a minute. Hey, Switch. Hey, Switch, don't you talk.
Let my feet run, not my mouth.
Oh, that's your boy.
Harry Nesbitt. All right.
That's cold. That was really cold. All right, look here. The Lord hath rolled, yes, but the preacher man takes it away.
I hear you. I heard that.
Say, Coach, what's this cab will out of place look like, anyhow?
Are you finished insulting each other? There's a brochure right in there. Take a look at that. Yeah, go ahead. Splendor in Mid-America, Nevada. Is that Mid-America, Nevada?
What's this look like?
There's another
count. Look at that. Here you go, Coach. You want some of this?
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
Hey, come on, man. Why'd you loosen up? I mean, get down.
Hey, listen, get your fill of that stuff now, because once we get to Cadwallader, they become athletes, not junkies, all right?
Junkies?
Yeah, junkies.
All right. So what do we got ourselves into this time?
Jump right in. Alive. Take the blows, but know that you'll survive. Put your marbles on the line.
If you lose it, it'll cry.
Win or lose, you've got the team.
So keep your eye upon that dream and go for it. Go for it. Go for it. Go for it. Now, 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 now. Go for it now.
Go for it.
I think we're being followed by the police.
What? Lord, man, they're after me. Come on, step on it.
Step on what? Are you kidding with this car?
Hey, man, how do they know you in this car, Turkey? Hey, Coach, just drive careful. Roll down the goddamn windows.
Get rid of your marijuana.
How am I going to do that?
Throw it out the window, man.
No, don't throw it out the window to see it.
Lord, man, they're going to bust us for sure.
Throw it out the window, man, will you?
Don't throw it out the window.
Hide it.
Ain't no place to hide it.
Throw it out the goddamn window, man.
Yeah, throw it out the window to the front. Eat it.
Are you crazy?
Eat it.
All of it?
How much you have?
1 pound.
Oh, God damn.
Well, eat it. Girl. Go ahead. Why don't I pull over? I'm pulling over.
Keep driving and eat.
I want to pull over right now. I want to pull over. Come on, swallow, swallow. Scoff it all up. I'm pulling over. It's not that bad. It's like, you know, rustic.
They're here.
Send them in.
Oh.
Wait a minute. Put some black music on.
If I didn't care more than words.
You can come in now.
Thank you.
Alden, how are you? Nice to see you again.
Come in. How are you?
How you been? Fine.
Oh, good. Fine.
Listen, I'd like you to meet the team that's going to make Cadwallader famous. This is DC Daisy.
Hello.
This is Leroy Monroe. This is Tommy White. And it's Bobby James, Mr. Gutkus.
Well, boys, welcome to Cadwallader. I'd like you to meet Howard Groper. He's our team manager.
How you doing, Howie?
If you need anything, you just ask Howard.
Yeah? How about new gym?
Oh, don't you worry about that. We're getting it repaired. Now, we want you to have the best that we can offer. Our academic standards are high, and when you leave here, you'll have an education. Second to none.
Cut out the boy, John. I mean, this is university. How are we going to get in?
You're in, man.
What'd I tell you that? I told you, right? All right.
All right. Howard, do you show them into their rooms?
You boys will follow me? Well, look, it's not really that bad. I mean, maybe some plants or some...
Plants? Now, that's a good idea. As a matter of fact, I even brought some seeds with me.
Oh, yeah. Well, see, the soil here is very fertile. Okay, you guys want to choose up living squads?
Yeah, hey, say, Hustler, you want to shack up with me, man?
Well, Nacon, I was thinking about shacking up with Swish. You know?
Hey, yeah, you got it, man. I'm with you.
Me and you, please.
All right. Second thought, I think I want my own room.
We all want our own rooms. Wait a minute, time, listen. I need to tell you this. The school is very overcrowded. There is no way. It is an absolutely inconceivable fact for you to have your own...
Do it.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
All right. Oh! Man! I'm waiting until the heat's off and I'm getting the hell out of here.
You gonna let Coach build a team and then walk out on him?
Hey, man, I got to look out for myself.
See, that's all you ever do, DC.
Bitch! Hey, man, I'll kick your ass! Hey, I don't take no shit from no fag!
Nah, Swish ain't no fag, man. I've known him since we were kids.
But then he's latent.
Late or early don't make no difference, man. A fag's a fag.
I heard that. We gotta find the fifth man out of that.
Hey, worst comes to worst, I shave off my beard and I'll play. All right, let's find out what kind of shape we're in.
Gentlemen,
good afternoon. I am Coach Green. Hello, Coach Green. Hello, Coach Green. Okay, now these gentlemen are the new additions to the team. I'm sure you heard about them. This is Hustler, this is DC, this is Swish, and this is Preacher. Okay, let me have a ball. Thank you. Let's get started right away. You stay on the court, and you stay on the court. Everybody else to the sideline. Hustler, Swish, stay on the court. DC, Preacher, come on, let's go. Off the court. Now, you guys are going to play defense. You set up. You guys play offense. Bring the ball down. Let's see what we got here. Okay. Good. I'm at the ball. Come on, quick. I'm at the ball. What's your name?
Larry,
it's very important. Always keep your body in between your man and the basket. Now, I know you're looking for the outside shot, but don't let him go in on you. Keep your body between, you hear me? Keep your body between the man and the basket. Let's try it again. Keep your body in between the man and the basket. All right. Okay, good try, Larry. You four guys off the court. Okay. Two on two, you four off. You get on the court. Preacher DC, bring the ball down. Come on, let's go, move it. I had a ball. Now, I want everybody to pay close attention to what Preacher just did, because you're never gonna see it again. That was a demonstration of Harlem Globetrotter bullshit. When you dribble, Swish, keep the ball low, no higher than your knee. How low can you go? No higher than your knee, not so much fancy stuff. You, what's your name?
Alec.
Alec, come over here.
Yes, sir.
Alec, I don't know if you're gonna make the team or not, but if you do, buy a jock.
Move it. Come on. Watch it.
I dunked the ball.
You hung on the rim. That's a technical foul. No hanging on the rim.
Damn, man. Basketball, fool.
Sorry, man.
You know. Sorry, my ass. Hey, get somebody else in
Preacher,
there.
Preacher, get back in there.
No.
Preacher. Embarrassing me. This looks very bad. This is my first day as coach. Now go back in there.
Hey, well, he better not do it again.
All right, come on, play ball. Let's go. Woo! Oh, come on, make up your mind what you're gonna do, hustler.
You mama!
Hey, just cool it. I don't want to hurt you. Now back off.
Just relax now.
All right.
Hey, now back off.
All right, let him go. Let him go.
You okay, buddy?
Let him go. He's okay. All right. What's your name, son?
Sam Newton, sir.
You played ball for CAD last year?
No, sir. I'm a freshman.
Freshman? Where'd you play high school ball?
I played football.
Yeah, I believe it.
But CAD doesn't have a football team.
Oh, so you thought you'd play a little defensive tackle out here, huh? All right, hustler, come over here. Come on, everything all right between you two guys? No hard feelings, honest mistake, restitution, all right? Okay, we're going to play a little 5-on-5, all right, Sam? I want you to play with the four boys from New York. The four guys from New York. All right, let's get on the other team. I want Larry.
Howard said you wanted to see us, coach.
Yeah, you could have took a shower first. It wasn't that important. It's all right. Sorry. Gentlemen, Krebs, Hollis, the game of basketball is not always won and lost by how good you play. Frequently, it's by how bad you can make the other guy play. Now, you agree with that, Hollis? Good, I'm glad you agree with that. Now, once in a while, it's necessary to use what you call a little psychology. Now, that's where you two come in.
Jesus, man.
All right.
Hey, man, he tripped me on purpose.
Sit down.
Sit down my ass, man.
You hit him already. But sit down.
Sucker.
You okay? You all right? You're not even bleeding. It's okay. It's all right. It's okay. Come on, get up. Get up. Get some air. Get up. Come on. Walk around a little bit. Let's go. Come on, Hollis. It's all right. This is a good job, Hollis. You got to learn how to duck, though. Very important. Good afternoon, Mrs. Tidwell.
Good afternoon, Mr. Green.
I understand we have a little bit of a problem here.
No, Mr. Green, you have a problem. Donald Clarence Dacey does not belong in this university.
Come on, I think you're overreacting a little bit.
Mr. Green, Mr. Green, the boy cannot read.
Well, that makes him an average college student.
I fail to find anything very amusing in that. I have had to flunk this boy on his English midterm.
How bad was it?
Zero.
Flunking it means that he won't be able to play basketball. Now, I'm sure Mr. Gutkus and the whole Cadwallader family are going to be very upset because we all realize what this boy can do for the university.
Destroy it scholastically.
Look, Mrs.
I don't know about Mr. Gutkus, but I'm sure that the whole Cadwallader family will understand.
Mrs. Tidwell, can
Ms.
I...
Ms. Tidwell.
Ms. Tidwell.
Nancy,
I'm not asking you to do anything immoral or illegal. All I'm asking you to do is give the boy another chance. Sports is his life. You know, the thrill of victory, the agony of defeat.
I've never known the thrill of victory.
Well, this is your chance. This is your opportunity. Every time Donald Clarence Dacey scores a basket, you know that you were partially responsible.
I'm afraid that...
Nancy, don't be afraid.
Can we have another margarita for the lady?
Oh, really, please. I
one
don't
more.
Drink.
Just
I,
one more.
This
I'll
is
have
already
another
more
one
than
later.
I should ever have.
One more for her. Bring her another one. I'll have one later. Nancy, what are you afraid of?
I'm afraid that's impossible. There's
what's
no...
Nothing's impossible. Look at yourself, Nancy. You're a well-educated, attractive, sexual white woman. You come from an upper-middle-class background in Nevada. And we're talking about a black kid from the streets of New York. Underprivileged, undereducated, grew up with crime, drugs, poverty. You know what it is to grow up in a ghetto? To have your spirit stunted before it can grow, before it can blossom? Nancy, I'm asking you to be more than an educator. I'm asking you to be a human being, a caring, feeling, thinking human being. His future is in your hands. Nancy, don't let us down.
Enter at your own risk.
Here you go. Merry Christmas. Oh, they cleaned up your room. Very nice.
What is this, man?
What is this, my friend? You got 1 week to pass your English exam. That's it.
What are you talking about? I couldn't pass that exam if I had a year.
Well, I had lunch for 2 hours today with Miss Tidwell. That's special detail overtime. So you're going to try and pass your exam.
Hey, look, I came here to play basketball and I get no education.
Look, if you don't pass this exam, you don't play basketball. Simple.
Fine. I don't play basketball.
And what kind of attitude is that? What do you have an attitude
about? Hey,
you got an attitude about this. You got an attitude. We'll call you Mr. Attitude. That's going to be your new name, Mr. Attitude.
What if I fail?
If you fail, you fail. That's the way of the world. Just try. All I'm asking you to do is make an honest effort. You can't do that for me?
Will you look at them books, man? I couldn't get through one of them in a week.
Just try. If there's something you don't understand, I'll give you a synopsis. Now, Swish
so
is...
what?
A synopsis, I'll boil it down for you if there's something you don't understand. Swish is going to help you. Any night you want, Swish is going to be there.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, now what's wrong with Swish? You got an attitude about Swish now. Attitude about everything. Mr. Attitude. Swish is an A student.
Yeah, well, that figures.
Yeah, that figures. Attitude. Everything's an attitude. I think this is alive. I just saw a movie. All right, follow me. Let's do it. Change pace. Change speed. Change direction. Pace. Speed. Direction. Very good, very good. That's three in a row. Okay, now, in The Devil and Daniel Webster, which was written by...
Binet
who? Binet Goodman? Who?
Raymond.
Stephen Vincent Binet, all right? I want to see a layup. No jump shot. Left hand. All right. Good. 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 All right. Let's do it again. Come on. Good. No jump shot. Layup. Layup. All right. All languages being imperfect, it does not follow that one should change them. Who said that?
Rick Barry. I don't know who said that.
Rick Barry. No, it was Dow Dawkins. Who said it? Voltaire said it.
Sounds like a faggot.
Everybody sounds like a faggot to you. Voltaire said it.
Voltaire.
Above your head. Beautiful, huh? So give him a good pass. All right, let's go. Come on, let's go there, Larry. Two hands above your head. Pass it. Let's go. Come on, move that ball. There you go. Sam, two hands. Give him a good pass. That's it, Sam. Better. Still stinks, but it's better. There you go.
Bacon has been accused of overrating what important science?
Physical sciences as they pertain to the development of man.
Right. Maybe you get to shoot a basket or two.
Preacher, watch the man on the ball. Don't leave the middle open, preacher. Don't leave the middle open, preacher, because this could happen. Very easy. That could happen, preacher. Describe the essence of the character of Gatsby.
What?
Describe the essence of the character of Gatsby. Everybody's watching the man and the ball. Everybody's watching the man and the ball. Everybody's keeping their eye on the man and the ball. The man and the ball.
Keep your eyes on the man and the ball.
I think we're ready.
DC, I think we're ready.
All right, Mr. Dacey. Please discuss the differences in style between Hemingway and Fitzgerald.
What's the matter with you?
I can't do it, man. I got these needles and pins in my hands and feet.
Mr. Green, I'm afraid it's a waste of time.
No, it's not. Just don't think about your hands and your feet.
How don't I think about it? Huh? I mean, how do I do that?
Now, the key to Hemingway, you see, is simplicity in language. Like, take the characters that he deals with. Like a dude in The Old Man in the Sea, just hop into his boat, go out and hook him a tuna, come back, he's cool. But now Fitzgerald, he deals with the rich folks, and the rich folks are a lot more complicated, you know? I mean, they're a lot more hung up. Less drama in his work, and a lot more psychology.
Is that all? You pass.
All right. God damn it, man, control yourself. Put none of that jive crap on me.
Sorry.
God damn fruit fly.
Go see you, show what you can do. Go see you, show what you can do. No challenge, no rules, can't beat the golden blue.
All right, execution. Let's go.
Kids sneaking into the movies.
Yeah, I did that quite a bit.
I bet you did.
Well, always sits on this side of the gym.
There's the cane. Looks bigger on TV, doesn't he?
Oh, well, he's big, all right. He just about runs the city and the whole state.
Move it! Move it!
Look at those guys. They don't look so threatening from up here, do they, Howard?
If you don't mind me saying so, Mr. Green. Getting State to play Cadwallader is going to be about as easy as getting the Ohio State Buckeyes to play football with Radcliffe.
Howard, you're 100% right. That's where you come in.
Me?
You. See that man down there? That man is enemy. I want to know everything about him, his fears, his family, his weaknesses. I want to know what he does on Saturday, what time he goes to the bathroom. I want to know everything about him. Howard, you understand what I'm asking you to do? I thought you'd have some conception of what was going on.
Intensity, intensity, come on!
not necessary, man. We're leading by 36 points.
Morning.
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 Hi.
Morning. Enter.
Coach, we made the Reno paper.
Let me see. Green Sparks Cadwallader. A new voice is being heard in basketball circles. Cadwallader University, which has been a poor sick cousin in the basketball community, seems to have received a shot of adrenaline. They stand undefeated after five games, trouncing their opponents by as much as 40 points and having scored not less than 100 points in every game. President Alton Gurkis has imported Coach David Green from New York. And this young man has fielded a team of top 10 caliber. State University, take notice! Howard, we got their attention. What do you got for me?
Very professional. Winning a project.
Coach, the man is as pure as ivory snow. I checked him out from the time he was born. I even tailed him for a week. I put a bug on his telephone.
You what?
You said he was the enemy. He has no mistress, that's for sure. No one-night stands, no problems at home. He does have one daughter, so I thought maybe we'd hire some young stud, you know, to hit on her. Work that kind of thing, you know. But she's married, she's got three kids. You know, she's not having any affairs, neither is Beau's wife. I checked her out completely. You know, they have been married for 35 years. So I thought what I'd do is I'd hire some hooker to hit on Beau. You know, but it would cost a few dollars, so I thought, you know, that I should speak to you. Mr. Green?
You put a bug on his phone?
Yeah. You want to pay the money?
No, Howard, I don't want to pay money for any hooker. Howard, you put a bug on his phone?
You want me to keep on top of it, or...?
Yeah, Howard, no more hookers or bugs on phones, but keep on top of it, all right?
I have some other things.
Yeah, all right. Howard, what's your major?
Political science.
Coach, your last win was a pretty easy one for you. You think that's going to benefit you at all, getting ready for your next game?
I think every win benefits you. Learn something from every game. Win or lose.
Well, how do you feel about state?
I think it would be a good game. I think it would be a close game. I think it would be a fair game.
I'd love to see that game.
So would I. All right, Hustle, let's go. Sharp cuts there. Make those cuts sharp. Sharper.
You both would like to see that game, Coach, but apparently Beau Winnegar wouldn't.
Well, I wouldn't say that he doesn't want to see that game. I would say that I understand the man's position. He's got one of the top 10 teams in the country. He's got a tremendous one and loss record. Now, why jeopardize that by playing a Bush League team like Cadwallader? From his point of view, it doesn't make sense.
Coach, are you saying that Beau Winnegar is afraid of you?
No, I didn't say he's afraid of me. I never said that. Don't print that, because if some, you know, every time I say something, something else gets printed. I said that I can understand his position.
Right. Thanks, Coach.
Let me have the basketball. Thank you, Coach. Let me have the basketball.
You!
Don't you ever take a shower?
Aw, come on, man. Let's go.
What the hell kind of game are you playing, Green?
Basketball.
Come on, you know what I'm talking about. Shooting your mouth off like that to all those reporters?
Now, wait a minute, Beau. I happen to have the highest respect for you, and if anybody said anything other than that, I'm going to sue them for libel.
Well, what's this talk about me being afraid of you?
Beau, I never said that. You know how those guys are. They're trying to get us into a shooting match.
Well, I don't need it, and I don't want it. I got enough headaches inside my own league.
All right. Hey, Beau?
Yeah?
I feel funny saying this, but you're one of my idols.
Well, thank you.
You know, even my style of coaching comes right out of your book.
Oh. You read my book?
Did I read your book? I wouldn't have got this job if I didn't read your book.
Well, I don't believe it, but it's a hell of a good story. I'd like to meet you sometime.
Well, I'd love to meet you. I mean, it'd be my privilege. How about Saturday night? Look, we have a game and you don't. Why don't you come over? I'm sure Mr. Gutkus would be happy to entertain you.
I might take you up on that. Put the dwarf on.
Put the dwarf on. Dwarf.
Hello, Bo.
Boy, you're unbelievable. That dude still thinks that he can whip.
Hey, that's just what I want the man to think, you know?
It's funny, though, guy.
Hello.
Hey, what's happening, Coach?
What's happening? A quarter to one, that's what's happening.
Well, Coach, you see, this gentleman and myself just went into business. This is the killingest shock to ever swim into a pool.
I heard that.
What are you doing with a cigar? What do you need
a cigar?
Look,
no, Coach.
What are you, a big shot?
No, look at this. I've been wasting my time saving souls.
Amen, brother.
It's a quarter to one. It's 11:15 curfew. Now go to sleep. Reggie got classes in the morning. Go ahead. Don't let this happen again.
All right, we'll see you morning, Coach. All right.
Yeah, good night. Hey, Leroy.
Yeah.
How much money you win?
I ain't got a chance to count it yet, you know. I got class in the morning. I'll see you later, all right?
Got class in the morning. Give me that cigar! Are you really the best?
God damn, Coach, you gotta learn how to knock.
You don't get yourself hurt.
Are you really the best at shooting? Is he really the best at shooting pool?
Coach, let me put it to you this way. He is to pool what Dr. J is to basketball.
You sure?
Yeah!
All right.
You see the pool just turning the room like
you're ready to cigar. What do you need a cigar for?
Oh, my goodness. Man.
Get on his ass at halftime. Hold him! Watch the screen! All right, come on, let's get in here. Let's go. Come on, move it.
Hey, is he here yet?
No.
Well, is he coming?
I don't know. The way you guys are playing, hope he never shows up. Let's go. Get in there. Howard, leave us alone for a little while. See if Winnie gets here, all right? Let me know when he gets here. What the hell's the matter with you? What, are you stoned or something?
Hey, man, back off.
You smoking dope? Not bad enough you're missing the easy layups. You're not even hustling out there.
Well, take me out.
Oh, yeah?
He's having an off night. Leave him alone.
Leave him alone. This is a basketball game, my friend. This is a group therapy session. We should be destroying this goddamn team out there. Winning by 8 points. They got momentum. They got everything. We could lose this game. You know why? He's playing like a big shit. And the rest of you are playing like little shits. All right, DC, listen, you have an off night. Stop shooting so much. Feed Creature. Creature's
hot. Yeah, I'm open out there, Coach. I mean, set some picks or
something. Shut up! Let me coach the team, all right, Preacher? Set some picks for him. He's hot. He's right. And why aren't you shooting, Swish? You got the boy, you got shots, take them. Don't be Mr. Nice Guy passing all the time. Take those shots when you got them. And Sam, you got 3 fouls on you ready. Watch that. I don't want you to foul out. And open up that offense. Open up the middle. Let Hustler get the ball. Feed him. You're not feeding him enough. And when you miss a shot, pound that offensive board. Pound it. Offensive board, Hustler. Important.
Man, you're putting us down. You know that?
Sorry. This game happens to be very important to me. It's important to everybody in this room. So let's do it, all right? All right, get a drink of water, go to the bathroom.
You got a nice gym.
We've just done the floor.
Yeah.
Looks good.
Oh, how you doing?
Hi there.
Coach?
Hello, boy. How are you?
Fine.
Glad to see you.
We've got a nice seat for you right over here.
No, no, no. I'll sit right here.
Okay, come on. All right. Let's go. Let's get out there. Let's go. Out there. Come on. Let's do it. Come on. All right. Let's go. Get out there. Bo.
Hey.
How are you?
How
are
you,
Coach? Thank you for coming. Thank you.
He is our man. Look at that score. What are you, resting your first string?
Well, Bo can tell you it's not nice to embarrass your opposition.
You mind if I sit down here? On the bench with you, I don't like to sit in the stands.
You want to sit on the bench with me? I've got a nice seat for you right up there. You don't want to sit there? Sure, go ahead. Sit on the bench. Well, what do you think? Cadwallader's finest.
What'd you do? Empty the ghetto?
I got to get to work.
Phlebitis of the leg. The man suffered. I mean, it's unbelievable. I went up to the Western White House, you know, in the, to San Clemente, you know, on the bus tour.
You had a good break, didn't I, Bo?
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Yeah. I don't know, Bo. You played an awful good game of pool.
Thank you.
Thank you, yeah.
Look on page. I think it's 47.
How many times do I have to tell you? How loud do you want to hear it? I'm not interested in you.
And then it's like nobody voted for him. I mean, he won, didn't he? Somebody had to have voted for him.
So, tell me something, Bo. What'd you think of my team?
You got no bench. Just one of your players fouls out, you're in trouble. And this kid, DC Dacey, he has any talent, he sure was hiding it.
Well, you know, I had an off night. Happens once in a while.
And that white kid should be playing linebacker for the Rams. And that kid, Swish, if he isn't gay, he's on his way.
Well, I'll tell you something, boy. I don't deal in personalities. He's a hell of a shot.
He's a great shot, but he's got no muscle. Get his little butt bounced off the court.
You know, Bo, you're really putting down my team. We won 114-70. It's not chopped liver.
With that competition?
Pax is pretty good. They're 8-2.
Tough luck.
8-ball in the side pocket.
Don't get nervous.
Don't worry.
It's not an easy shot. Be careful. You know, Bo, I'll tell you something. If I didn't know what a gentleman you were, I think I was hustled.
There was a time I made my room and board with the pool cue.
So you need my $40? What am I, a millionaire, you know? Hey, Leroy, come on in here. Come on in here. I want you to meet Bo Winnegar. Say hello to Leroy Monroe, my best player.
Hello, Mr. Winnegar.
Leroy, I want to tell you, you're one hell of a good player.
Thank you, sir.
Another game, Dave?
Oh, no, forget it. I'll play you friendly, no money, right?
It's no fun if there's no wager.
Could I play Mr. Winnegar?
I don't take money from students, son.
Look like we've been fun.
You really want to play?
Yeah, definitely, Coach.
You want to play 8-ball?
Yeah, sure.
I'll tell you what, he played a good game tonight. I'll put up his $20. What do you say? Take my money.
Rack him up.
All right, solid.
Rack him up, solid.
Hey.
Here's another $20.
Hi. Never figured you'd pass on a party.
I was just getting some air. I'm going back now.
You mad at me?
No, not mad at you.
What's the matter? You afraid somebody see us alone together?
We're not together.
What is this?
We're just talking, that's all.
I don't bite you, though.
Hey, man, will you swat your mouth? Somebody, you talking like that, they'll run us both off campus.
Oh, no, I gotta watch even what I say to my own teammate.
What are you doing now, man? Crying? Hey, look, you're 19 years old. You walk around here like a goddamn woman. You talk like one. You even got feelings like one.
Do I lie? Do I cheat? Am I some kind of criminal? Why the hell are you talking to me this way?
Because you make me uncomfortable, that's why.
You think I'd be interested in somebody like you?
But you watch your mouth.
But what do you want to talk about, basketball?
Hey, man, I got to go. Come on, Swish. Hey, look, man, pull yourself together, will you? I gotta go.
No. It's your goddamn bench. You stay.
You know, he got more electoral votes than Hunter did. He was an amazing campaigner.
What are you, glue all?
Well, I mean, I was just trying
to... There is nothing about you that interests me. Do you get that?
Another one, Mr. Winnegan?
How much do I owe you?
How much you owe? You owe me. $4,920.
I can't believe it. I'll have to write you a check.
I don't want your check.
But I don't have the cash.
What do you mean you don't have the cash? Was that a joke?
That's all right, Coach. I don't want your cash.
Well, what do you want? Want to play basketball against this team 2 weeks from Saturday?
Yep.
That's impossible. You know that.
Hey, Bo. That's not impossible, because you owe me almost $5,000. Tell you what I'll do. One more game. You win, your debt is clean. You lose, you play us 2 weeks from Saturday.
Rack 'em up.
Okay. Let's call for break.
Heads.
Tails.
Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch, you set me up.
All right.
Hey, Bo, I'll see you 2 weeks from Saturday. All right.
Hey.
You like that guy call me a son of a
bitch?
What did I do?
New York bus in 2 hours.
Where you going?
New York.
New York. You don't like the bus, you're gonna walk?
If I have to.
Wait a minute. Just calm down. Now, why are you throwing away your whole future to go back to some condemned building in New York? What about everybody else's future? What about Preacher? What about Hustler? What about me?
Coach, it's personal. I'm sorry. I don't know what it is, man, but it's something real weird.
What the hell is going on? Tell me. Let me help you. Will you tell me?
All right, man. Do you want two fags on your team?
What?
I think I'm a fag.
Come on.
I'm serious, man. I never felt this way in my whole life.
What way?
Look, man, don't tell anybody. It's that goddamn swish.
Is that what this whole thing is about? Swish? You find yourself attracted to swish. You find yourself watching that cute little ass as it glides down the court. You're turned on by swish. You want to hug him and you want to kiss him. You're overprotective. Nothing wrong with that, DC.
No. Not you, too.
There's nothing wrong with me, and there's nothing wrong with you either.
Man, when you start looking at a guy like you would at a girl, I mean, damn.
Yeah, yeah. But that doesn't apply when the guy is a girl.
What?
Swish. Girl.
Man.
How you doing?
All right.
I just wanted to apologize for the way I treated you. I mean, I really shouldn't have treated you that way.
Okay.
Can I sit down? You're real attractive, you know that. I guess I was about 14 when I realized I liked boys.
I think you better go.
Hey, come on. You said you was lonely. I mean, I understand that. I've been lonely lots of times.
DC, cool it. You're out of line.
How about if I move in with you?
Out.
Hey, go on. Okay. If you want to let me move in with you, at least let me see you. We can go off campus. Restaurants. Movies.
Will you get out of here?
Motels. I'm crazy about you, baby.
If you don't get out of here in 10 seconds, I'm calling campus security.
No, don't be that way, Roberta.
You son of a bitch!
Roberta James. You know, I was at the bus station today ready to leave town when the man told me.
God, woman, I feel like I'm born again. Lord, you're the crinest woman I have ever seen. You know that?
Hello, stranger. Hi, Mom. If I'm still Mom, you're still my daughter.
Oh, I'm making some tea. You want some?
That would be nice. That would be nice.
What do you mean that's why you're here? Mom, please, don't get involved.
He sent me this ticket to go see this big game in Reno. It means a lot to him that I should be there. And I would like to, too, but I'm 65 years old. I've never been on an airplane in my whole life. It scares me. Would you go with me?
Mom, I can't.
You're not working. It's on the weekend.
Mom, I'll tell you what, okay? I'll drive you to the airport. I'm going to put you on the plane, but I cannot go. Mom, please be reasonable.
I don't know what that is anymore. I used to think I did. Jan. I had a chance once to go on an airplane. Me and my husband were young then, and his uncle wanted him to go with him to Los Angeles and open a business. Saul wanted to go. Not me. I was scared. In 1945, Los Angeles was like going to Poland. Besides, my family was here, my friends. So Saul said, come on the plane, just to visit, see for yourself. I wouldn't go. Because I was a strong lady, he stayed. I wonder often, what would have happened if we'd have moved to Los Angeles? An easier life? Would he have lived an extra day, another year? I have one son, and as much as I love him, I've always thought he was a little crazy. Now I find out he's a big celebrity. He wants me to see for myself.
Game. He scored 43.
Mr. Green?
Yeah.
I'm Officer Wedgwood with the Benson Police Department. Can I talk to you for a minute?
Yeah.
I hate to be the one that breaks bad news, especially on a night like tonight. The New York police spotted your team's picture in Newsweek magazine.
I have a warrant for DC's arrest.
Now, I'm late. This is the last one here, okay?
There you go.
There you go.
All right, now wait a minute. Let's look at this rationally. A man is worried. He's got a right to be worried. We all should be worried. But the cops got men all over the place. The guy tries anything, they're going to grab him.
Before he shoots?
Look, why don't we all go out there and do our jobs and let the cops do theirs?
You expect Preacher to go out there on that floor?
Yeah.
Say, Hustler, man, cool it. Ain't nobody twisting my arm.
Yeah, you're a fool, then.
Hey, man, if Father Celestial wants me, man, he's gonna get me. And it don't matter where and it don't matter when. So, man, let's just go play ball, all right?
Let's play ball. Come on, let's get out there.
Aren't you worried?
The dude ain't aiming at me.
But he knew Preacher was here. How long before the cops know you're here?
For running the numbers, man. Hell, he wouldn't go to New Jersey to pick me up. Hey, look, stop worrying. Damn.
Doesn't matter. Win or lose, when this game is over, I'm Roberta James again.
Yeah. We better catch up.
Swish. He's got no muscle. Now work on it. And that white guy, Newton, he's a bull. Get him to foul out. There's no bench.
I bet you wants to whip him.
Roar! Arrgh! Come on! Let's go!
Let's go!
Stay! 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 Stay!
Damn, sounds like goddamn war down there.
Don't worry about them. We'll shoot off our own guns tonight, huh?
Thank you.
down.
DC and Newton's supposed to be the weak players out there, and they're killing us.
Then start putting pressure on them, you assholes! Let's go! Stay!
All right, Coach, I can't do nothing.
All right, no problem.
All right, gentlemen, I don't have too much to say. We're leading by 4 points. It's been a pretty good first half. I think we got a big psychological advantage going into the second half, so let's take advantage of it. Now, Mr. DC Dacey, AC Ducey, you got to control your temper. I'm telling you this as a friend, not as a coach, because you're going to get your ass kicked out of the game.
They're coming down on Swish.
I know they're coming down on Swish, but that's part of the game, and he knows it too, all right? Lighten up.
Yeah, I gotta do something to stop that dude beat. He's killing me on the boards.
Yeah, I was gonna address myself to that problem. Preacher, I'm gonna start Hollis the second half. I want beaten out of the game. You know what I'm asking you to do? Figured you'd have some idea. Stay on the man. Give him a little room.
All right, come on, this is for all the models.
Let's get that tip. Let's get the tip. Let's set up the play.
Part of the game.
A man's jugular vein is not part of any game. It's the same as mine.
No, it's true.
Do the best you can.
Who do I call a nigger, Coach?
I'll call anybody a nigger. Just check.
Yes, sir.
You played better tonight than I ever thought you were capable of.
I tried, Coach. I really tried.
You played your best game when it counted. You got nothing to be ashamed of, believe me.
Yeah, but we could lose. We never lost before.
I have. You don't die for it. Good game.
Shitty thing to do. I apologize.
Okay, it's okay.
Right, don't look around, just listen to me. There's a cop here with a warrant for your arrest. I'm gonna serve it as soon as the game's over.
Huh? How do you know that?
Told me before the game.
Oh. You made a deal with him so I could play ball.
So why tell me now? I decided you had the right to go. Whatever you do is all right.
I just need a nice bag.
Come on, go
eat. Hey, Coach, is it broken?
No, it ain't broken. All right, Stavey's gonna be manning the ball at all times. Don't let him get in front of you. You're listening? Don't let him get in front of you. Go ahead.
At least there's no swelling.
Hey, man, look, I've had this before. Just give me 5 minutes to rest.
Want me to bandage it?
No, Howard, why don't you go and watch the game, man? I'll be all right.
I hope so. Without you, we haven't got a chance.
Yeah, we got 8 points.
That lasts 2 minutes. Look, I'm sorry. I just didn't think it would mean this much to me.
Oh,
him, Larry. Watch him.
Kind of running I got a horse for.
Say, DC, how's your ankle, man?
It's all right. Hey, Breach, they got your man.
Are you serious?
He's in the police car.
All right, hey, let's play ball.
Hey, we got 2 minutes and 59 seconds to go. Let's do it. All right.
You want to try that IU play?
Well, no. I want to go with C-14, all right? Now, will you take it with the legs?
That's too risky. You know
what we need. Yeah, I know what we need. We need some fresh manpower.
Or something like that.
What do you mean something? Are we going?
I'll be right back.
What do you mean you'll be right back? What do you mean you'll be right back?
Now, let's go!
Stay!
Well, there's 15 seconds left to go. I want the shot taken with 5 or 6 seconds to go.
Come on, Blue. Let's play ball.
Hey, they're stalling! They're stalling! It's a technical foul!
Everybody goes...
He's a transsexual.
He's a goddamn girl.
What the hell? Are those for real?
Come on, let's play ball.
Yeah, let's play ball.
David!
Let me down. How you doing? Did you see?
I saw. We got here late.
Well, how much? We? Jan? You wait here, I'll be right back.
Take your time.
Congratulations, you played one whale
thanks
of a ball
thanks
game.
A lot. Hey,
listen,
you.
I got a little bad news for you. I'm Officer Wedgwood, and I have to arrest you. Look, it's a first offense, and I'm sure you'll only get probation.
Okay, I'm ready.
Good man.
But Carl, excuse me, we can work this all
oh,
out.
Oh, everything's taken
no,
care of.
Listen, all too. Carl, you everything is all right. The house. I got all some 100-proof bourbon up there. Come on, we'll talk this whole thing over. We'll just talk it right.
Rotten.
Why?
Because I should have been here
no,
with you all
you
along
should.
Here.
No, why should you be as crazy as me?
You should see yourself in there. I'm so proud of you. It's obvious this is what you're meant to be.
What about my stomach?
What about your stomach?
Stomach's killing me. Look at this. I've been taking these things all night.
You can give me one.
David Green,
I am going to make you a deal.
You're going to make me a deal?
I'm going to make you a deal.
And what's the deal?
You take care of your team.
Yeah.
And I'm going to take care of your stomach.
That's not a bad deal.
Yeah.
I got another deal.
Why?
When I first met you, I had this red Firebird 450. Mm-hmm. I used to drive around crazy all the time. What if I get Henry to sponsor me and I enter in this year's Indy 500?
Oh. Okay. They're calling you in there. It's basketball or nothing, huh?
Oh, I definitely don't want to lose you again.
Uh-huh.
Basketball.
Chance is here, grab it now before it disappears. Lady Luck is here today, move before she runs away. Keep your eye upon that dream and go for it.
Don't hang back, for life's too short. Second guessing is a loser's sport. Throw your backs against the wall. Now at least you got the ball. Keep your eye upon that dream and go for it.
Now is not the time to sit and shiver.
Now's the time to stand and be delivered.
Just pretend it lies. Take the blows, but know that you'll survive. Put your marbles on.